Please welcome Vice President Global Advanced Manufacturing at Lear, Jennifer Johnson.
All right, good morning. My name is Jennifer Johnson, and I'm here to share a glimpse into the journey of Palantir Foundry at Lear Corporation. Lear is a global leader in automotive seating and e-systems. Our team of more than 173,000 employees across 37 countries designs, manufactures, and delivers advanced technologies to the world's leading automakers. With over 100 years of heritage, Lear is the largest U.S.-based automotive supplier, proudly headquartered in Michigan. Guided by our commitment to innovation, operational excellence, and sustainability, Lear's global team is shaping the future of mobility with solutions that enhance comfort, safety, and efficiency. The automotive industry dynamics and resulting operational complexities are endless. To assist our team in navigating through the realities of today's marketplace, we are working to support our employees and our customers through our Palantir Foundry platform, and we haven't looked back. Never underestimate the ability of a small group of dedicated people to change the world. Isn't that how the saying goes? And a couple of years ago at Lear, it was exactly that. A small group of dedicated people who built our first use case with Palantir. It's easy for me to stand here and summarize the road that we've traveled since that initial use case. And depending on where you are in your journey with Foundry, you already know it's no joke. It's not an out-of-the-box solution. It's not a flip-the-switch project. Value through Foundry is extracted through a deep relationship with the Palantir team and a long-term investment of time and resources from within an organization. So back to that initial use case. It built the foundation of manufacturing production support at Lear. And from that initial use case, we built more, involving our manufacturing execution system, integration, and further monitoring applications. Next, we built into our supply chain. And that positions us to our current ambition: dynamic decision-making in support of just-in-time seat assembly. So let's turn our attention to JIT operations to understand more about what I'm referring to. For automakers to offer a broad range of options for customers like you and me, their models are designed to accommodate thousands of end-item vehicle versions. So as a Tier 1 supplier, Lear's processes must be optimized to meet very tight requirements. So I'm talking about product complexity delivered just in time with the highest quality and, of course, the lowest cost. Lear only has a 4-hour broadcast window from the time a fixed customer order is placed to the time a seat must be present at the seat install point within an automaker's assembly plant. There are, on average, 350 unique part numbers that are picked in stage that are components within a seat. After assembly, all seats are inspected and tested for fit and function. They are then readied for a sequenced delivery to our customer assembly plant. The point I'm trying to make here is that a just-in-time seat operation is a very intense environment. We're shipping seats at 60 jobs an hour, 24 hours a day, 5 days a week. Considering Lear's global scale of over 175 just-in-time plants, thousands of decisions are made daily to both secure on-time delivery and also optimize our processes. So, sounds like a great opportunity for an AIP-powered Foundry application, don't you think? Well, we thought so. So let's take a closer look and join the team in Flint, Michigan to see what's going on today. Welcome to the JIT Control Tower, where operations teams start their day. The Control Tower is a real-time, bird's-eye view of Lear's operation. On the left, we see the production line status. It's a continuous influx of orders and deliveries. And on the map, we see a high-level routing of incoming material from Tier 2 suppliers located across North America. These are components and subsystems en route from other Lear sites or other third-party suppliers. So how do we do it? How do we orchestrate the convergence of a continuous flow of customer demand with the right material and the right resources on hand exactly at the right time? We do this through dynamic production scheduling. To optimize production scheduling, we combine the expertise of our operations team and our engineering team with Foundry's AIP horsepower. In this view, we're experiencing the Kanban board. This is a pipeline of activities and actions that together execute to a schedule that our teams monitor. During a shift, dynamic line scheduling is informed through the integration of multiple applications. If you remember those use cases I mentioned earlier, these applications reconcile things like inbound material availability, real-time production throughput, and finished good inventory capacity. At the most left is our exceptions board, and our planners spend their time there, interfacing, triaging, and closing concerns in material availability or production alerts, anything that may impact our most time-sensitive deliveries. And our teams are trained to react to exceptions. At times, our customer demand is within that four-hour window that they set. This means customers are asking us to break that schedule that we planned and expedite what we all call a hot job. AIP alerts us now of a hot job, and our ops team engages to assess the best alternatives within the schedule to deliver. Planners run the AI agent, our scheduling agent, and it's powered to assess our bill of materials and standard labor content involved. The scheduling agent offers options to allocate the job during the shift. The resulting impact to the schedule and inventories on hand is considered. So I point out a hot job as an example. It's a perfect example of how AIP and the Lear team up on the production floor. Foundry delivers the decision layer, while the plant operations team brings practical product and supply chain and manufacturing know-how. Engineering assesses complexity through simulation, while Foundry ingests inputs, finds the best slot, and makes a proposal. Last, operations reviews the plan, considers the next best alternative, and approves or escalates if needed. When ready, the job is placed and written back to Lear's MES system. As we build the JIT control tower and new AI agents, we have our global manufacturing team in mind. We just reviewed one line and one plant. Multiply that by hundreds of plants and as many operations teams making those thousands and thousands of decisions daily. I find the most rewarding part of deploying Foundry applications are the aha moments, and we all have them. It's the moment a production planner realizes he no longer must spend hours each day poring over Excel spreadsheets and on conference calls, reconciling on-hand inventory with his Mexican counterparts. And it's the moment the plant manager realizes she now has a digital assistant supporting her ability to execute more effectively in her 24-hour-a-day, 5-day-a-week operating rhythm. In conclusion, Foundry allows us to focus on what matters, keeping our plants running smoothly and delivering the highest quality product to our customer. And many thanks to the Palantir team for supporting us along the way as we solve for our greatest opportunities. Thank you so much.